Our series, America's Child Care Crisis, is looking at the gigantic challenges facing families and daycares in the child care system overall. The U.S. Treasury Department says parents with at least one child under five currently need to devote about 13% of their income, that's pre-tax income, to child care. The department considers that unaffordable for most Americans. Well, duh. This morning, we're looking at the impact of the crisis on the economy and some creative solutions for parents. And to help us with that, we're joined by Jill Schlesinger, CBS News business analyst, and Parents Magazine digital content editor, Julia Dennison. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
Jill, let's begin with you here. The question of the burden of child care on American families. We heard 13%. It's hard to put that into real numbers. Could you do it for us? What's it add up to?
Absolutely. Well, we have a care.com survey that came out. 57% of families spent more than $10,000 on these costs last year. 59% they're going to spend more this year. Just to put that in context, the median household income in the United States is about $67,500. If you take $10,000 and you do the math, this is 14, 15%, sometimes 18, 20%. It is a huge burden on American families.
And then, Julia, when parents make a calculation, do I stay home or do I go to work, they look at that cost and they think, am I really going to make enough to offset it?
Absolutely. And it is an impossible decision that many parents, especially moms, are making, because we saw that one in three moms of kids under the age of three actually left the workforce during the pandemic because of decisions like this. And it's impossible. It's, do I, if I'm taking my paycheck, is the same as what I'm putting out for daycare? Why should I go to work?
Right.
But, you know, we've covered this on parents, and there are many benefits to continuing. It depends on what you want, right? Because there are many moms who do want to stay at home, but if you want your career, there are still benefits to going back to work.
The disruptions can have a long-term effect.
Right, and on your career, absolutely. Yeah, it can set you back years, and it can set the economy back decades. We've seen that as well. And, you know, I think it's really important for your kids to see you working, your girls as well as boys. Yeah. Seeing working women is important these days.
That's what you want, for
sure. Now, the Biden administration is talking about using funds to help out with child care costs. What does that actually look like?
Well, it's interesting because I think the administration is making the point that the public sector is really where the action has to begin. Private sector just can't do this. The cost of running daycare centers is enormous. It is not something you can say like, oh, let me have a robot take care of it. It's not scalable. So the way the Biden administration looks to present to solve this problem is to say, let's cap child care costs at 7%.
Gotcha.
Now, it'll be on a sliding scale. It'll depend where you live. But this is a very big program. It would be a breakthrough for the United States, which so far hasn't done a lot to help the families of America deal with their child care costs.
Julia, if this bill is not successful, if it doesn't pass, if states and the federal government do nothing, which, let's be honest, there's a possibility that's the case, what options do parents have?
Sure. So I think it is imperative for employers to show empathy to parents, working parents these days. Do whatever they can when it comes to benefits. You know, make sure there are dependent care accounts that you can apply for. So you can put up to $5,000 of tax-free money towards the child care. That's really important. But then it's also about making a plan and then a backup plan, because you might have child care, but, you know, these daycares, these schools are shutting down when there's a COVID case. So what's your plan B? Is that your village? Is that your friends in the neighborhood that you can have a COVID bubble with, where you've all been vaccinated and you trust each other? But you have to make that plan, and then you have to make it again. And it's about budgeting, too, and just knowing what you can afford and what you can't afford. But it's really, really hard. We reported on the fact that child care costs have gone up 40% in the pandemic.
Did you say 40?
40%. And that is a huge strain on parents.
Help us understand, guys, why it's so expensive. I'm blown away by 40% increase.
Well, right? Well, first of all, a lot of daycares are closing. Just because they couldn't
find quality people, also hard.
Correct. Yeah. Couldn't find, you know, hard to find that quality people. A lot of we don't value childcare employees in the United States the way
we
should.
Talking about that, yeah.
Right. So we don't pay them enough. So they're looking for other jobs out there.
Yeah. If I could just jump in here, $12.24 an hour is what the average early childcare provider earns. Now, if you are that person, your childcare center closed down, and now what do? You don't have a job. You go take a warehouse job where you can make $18 an hour, regular hours with benefits, and you are so far ahead. These people have families too. And you know what? Childcare is an industry. it's very hard. You cannot leverage any sort of technology or advancements to help. This is an issue that is going to plague the United States. And we are far behind other developed nations, by the way. We spend $500 per kid under the age of five. Other developed nations, rich countries, spend $14,000 on average per child.
Yeah, listen, I'm not knocking warehouse or any other job, but I can't think of anything more important than how your children are cared for. Nothing. Thank you, Julia.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me.
Always a pleasure to see you both.